what you know. Yeah, you cannot see me, the windows is tinted. Yeah, drive around right in that Bentley. Hey, you drive around right in that Bentley. Hey, but your shit, it just be rented. Yeah, but that is none of my business. No, money won't stop me, go straight to the top. Believe it or not, you like getting the same. Yeah, yeah. She know I'm a rock star. Looking at my chain, on my diamonds right on. Turned the way up, I ain't getting tired. And if you wanna race, then we gonna ride. Yeah, you know.
Eagles going up against Ryan's Falcons.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League presented by EA Sports. A few moments ago, it was Desmond Trufant of the Falcons making their way out of the tunnel to the delight of this sold-out crowd as his guys get set to do battle with the Philadelphia Eagles. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Shift together here from the D-line. Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
And that's the way to get things started the first time you touch the football on the road. And you have to believe all week long, all they've talked about is, okay, going into a hostile environment, we're the visiting team. How do we take control of this ball game early? That's one way right there. No fear, guys. And if they had any, it's probably gone after that run.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Smith catches left side. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. It'll be a loss of 1. And that's going to lead to a third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
And you would have to think an obvious passing situation here on 3rd and 9. Here's Foles. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
I better raise my voice a little bit here because one thing we can already tell, even in the first year in the league with this new stadium, it's going to get loud in this place.
Yeah, the old place was loud, but I think we're getting a sense that this place is going to be louder.
Yeah, they're riding that momentum of that 2016 team that finished their year in the Super Bowl.
Here is the punter, Jones, as he gets this one away. And it's taken in at the 9. Oh, what a move. And now the spin. A great return there. Bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And the Falcons will be taking over 1st and 10. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. Freeman again. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
Well, so many times we look at a short run, and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Here's Ryan. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by a former first-round pick, Patrick Robinson. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a 1st down. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the 2nd and 3rd levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Now a 1st carry for LeGarrette Blount. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
That's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. 2nd and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving the running back a crease to run through, and has a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a 3rd down.
Now Foles. And Jeffrey's got it. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 18 yards there and a 1st down. Alshon Jeffrey, so dangerous even when a defender's near him.
He's got such a big body, ability to run, positions himself well, excellent control. And you're exactly right. Even if people are draped on him, he often comes up with the catch. He really symbolizes what people are looking for in receivers in today's NFL.
He'll look to throw. And he dumps it off to Blount. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll be 3rd down. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, but they're still a yard short here with 4th down forthcoming.
I can't say that I was really in love with the play call there. A draw in that situation, I know it's a risk-reward call. If it works, he walks in. But otherwise, you're bringing up a really tough 4th down situation.
Now Jake Elliott for the field goal try. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And the kick by Elliott is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So they take it all the way to the 1-yard line, but in the end, they opt for three.
I know if this was a video game, they never would have gone for the field goal because, Brandon, who kicks field goals in video games? But you got to make sure you get points, and that was as easy a three as you can get.
You kick field goals in video games. That's who kicks field goals in video games. Atlanta now coming out on the field. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Mills, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. He lost 2 there. And it's 3rd down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Got to credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Back to throw here. And that's caught by Smith. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And he rifles one incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jay Ajayi there out of the backfield. 3rd down here. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
They'll set up to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. 1st down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
And, Brandon, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines as extra defenders, and you want bigger people.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Kenyon Barner from 4 yards out. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He goes underneath to Freeman. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll bring up a second down. From the gun, it's Ryan. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Brandon Graham in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Third and long. It's Ryan. Being checked. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Fletcher Cox. He's the one to get him this time. And back-to-back sacks are going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Matt Bosher now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Calling a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. To play here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. 6 yards to go here on second down. They'll set up a throw. Ertz has it left side, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. This is Ajayi, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
That was a good, strong run there. While one picked up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run, they got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
Now a play fake here on first down. This will be caught inside the 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Here's Ajayi. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Now third down, and he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Jay Ajayi taking it in from a yard out. And the Eagles add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Elliott on for the extra point. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
He's going to let this one go deep. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Bleedy Ray Wilson. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
I know that's their first connection in this game, but you and I both know that Julio Jones is without a doubt his quarterback's favorite target.
Oh, yeah, Matt Ryan loves this guy. Who wouldn't?
Yeah, and the reason that he's that is because of his dependability. And quarterbacks have to have that from their receivers, meaning they know where they're going to be when they're running certain routes. They don't break them on them. They don't change them up and do their own freelance stuff and put their quarterbacks in bad situations. Matt Ryan has ultimate trust in Julio Jones.
Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. They run with Ajayi. And he's brought down. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Third quarter starts with a run by Freeman. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
On second down, Freeman. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. On third down, Ryan. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Another drive comes and goes. Still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
Here we go on fourth down with Ryan. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. That was a pretty good job by the defense, I thought, right? I mean, they had to go to their check down, but still were able to get it done for the first.
Agreed. Anytime you can force him to come back to a receiver that's a little bit shorter in the route, you've done your job on defense, but still, they pick up the first down and get a fresh set.
Huge fourth down conversion. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. On the screen, this is Coleman. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And they'll be facing a third and 12. Here's Ryan. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 35. They find some open field here. There he goes, right side. And he'll score. Touchdown. This D wanting to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think I'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he is knocked down from the side. Yeah, here now come the Falcons. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that.
He's got a man complete. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard at the 38-yard line. It's a big play there for Atlanta. 43 yards. Now Ryan on first down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that'll make it second down.
Brandon, more and more offenses are going to the philosophy of using every inch of the field to try and spread things out. And when you're running back and catch the ball as well, that can only help your offense.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. And the third down pass falls incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. To throw is Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 there. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Now Ryan. And now here is another interception. Picked off inside the five. Then he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They are excited about where they are in this game.
And a nice gain of 21 yards. They'll look to throw now on first down. They set up the screen to Ajayi. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
He's going to fire one, and that's caught inside the 35. And a big tackle there as the defender runs right through him. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Foles. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. He had a great read there from his free safety position. And, Charles, you know with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser-focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what they're doing.
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. Well, they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Steps away to his left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Well, hey, in the spirit of the holidays, let's have some fun. You sent out something on social media last week I thought was great. You asked it, if Santa Claus was in the NFL, what position would he be playing?
Well, we got some great responses, yeah, too, on that one.
What was the theme?
A lot of people looked at him as a defender.
And my goodness, another interception. He's picked off at his own 47. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. Gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against the Eagles, and I believe it's against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And it's second down. Here's Foles. And that is incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
The Eagles on third down. Six conversions and nine tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This is third and 10. He'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as well.
Now, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away. Turns into a nice play.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And Elliott puts this one through. And the lead increases even further. It's 27-0 now. So they had great field position, but a three-play drive that actually goes backwards, and then they kick the field goal.
And I think the key sequence in there, the key phrase you just gave us, a three-play drive. Had the momentum, great field position, unable to move the football.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Now a hit and a loose football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. No, let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not in your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up the score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble, now great field position. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
The Eagles on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third and 10.
Now Foles. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. And we'll begin it with a field goal try here. This will be spotted at the 37, so it's a 47-yard attempt. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And this will get out of bounds. No worries there, though. That still goes as a touchback. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Add one, tell me once. Either.
And Freeman lost the football, and the Eagles have recovered.
Okay, this isn't one where you want to take the game tape and hold it up as an example, do you? I mean, you talk about frustrating all the way through. And that last error, I think that crystallizes it, doesn't it?
Absolutely. That's been representative of their entire game still being shut out. And down inside the 15 he goes. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. They'll look to throw here on first down. Going underneath to Blunt. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll be a second down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Now he's flushed out right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. LeGarrette Blount was the intended target, and it's 3rd and 4.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6.
They'll look to throw. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. They run for it with a Ajayi. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. They go play action here on first down. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Caught on the right side by Jones. And a big hit. Knocked down sideways near the 25. Decent chunk of yardage still left here. 2nd and 7. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. And now here is another interception. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. The number 7, usually lucky here, not for him. 7 picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened 6 times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he had won a Heisman Trophy in college, so sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career, but when you're talking about 1 game, 7, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw 7 picks. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good
But then,
and he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. Brooks Reed coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it'll be fourth down. And now they're going to go for it. This isn't fourth and inches. This is fourth and 14. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. He'll drop to throw. And Jeffrey's got it. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Adrian Claiborne in there to get him. His second sack now of the afternoon. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Now it's Ajayi. He's to the 10, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. So another score there, and often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
Yeah, they are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest,
don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as a Eagle pressure. Too much this time. Down he goes. Vinny Curry. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Now Ryan on second down. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Jeffrey with a catch left side. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They'll drop the throw. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. He'll look to throw. And it's caught. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. They'll try to run with a Jay. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Elliott now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guy.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. On first and 10, it's Ryan. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Fletcher Cox in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
Ready! Ready! There we go.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now it's Ryan. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot.
Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt, the number 0, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that 0 on the scoreboard for them, going along with those zeros in the time column, too.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we say so long, everybody.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports.
Today, there's going to be a pair of wide receivers looking to make big plays on the field. It's Jones' Falcons going up against Cook's Patriots.
Larry, we are about an hour's drive southwest of downtown Boston in the area known as Patriot Place, Gillette Stadium here in Foxborough. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with the Atlanta Falcons. Now, Deion Lewis to return. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Shifty Deion Lewis. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
On second down, here's Brady. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
A first carry for the tailback, Devontae Freeman. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's gonna go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats, but really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Ryan hit, and he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Ryan. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 33, and they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Adrian Claiborne in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. And they're going to go soft on the corners.
20. We got three.
Brady to throw on second down. He's going to rifle one deep left into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. They set themselves behind the chains, tried to get it all back in one play, and it backfired.
Didn't it feel like a pitcher working his way into a 3-0 count, right? You're behind. What do your coaches always tell you? Get it back one pitch at a time. In this case, they tried to get it back right away, and it didn't work out.
And he's finally taken down, but not before he reaches the 14. A big run there by Freeman. 42 yards. Freeman again, a first down carry. He's going to get four out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. Here's Ryan. And down he goes, Lawrence. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Lawrence Guy in there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And the Falcons are out to a 3-0 advantage. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
Here's Bosher to kick it away.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Brady gives this one to Lewis. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. Now Brady throwing on second down. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Brady looking to throw on 3rd and 2. He's letting it fly for Cooks. So they took a shot there on 3rd down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? 3rd and short, they elect to throw for it. And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on 3rd and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on 4th down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and pick it up with Lewis. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. So just shy of midfield, they tried it. Didn't work out. What did you think?
I thought that they should have punted the ball away. Should have gotten rid of it and played defense with better field position. Look, I'm as aggressive as anyone wanting to go for it on offense, but in this situation, it doesn't.
First half.
I don't know that there's any risk. I mean, what's the reward for your risk here? I would not have done that. My only explanation is this coach, he may want to be up here in the booth with us. We may have a 3-man booth starting next week if he keeps up with those decisions.
And he's going to go out of bounds. He takes this one down shy of the 20. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. This is Freeman on 1st and 10. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We also have got the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up 1st and goal.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game in the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down.
2nd goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
So the sack pushes him back, and now 3rd and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Ryan. On the screen, this is Coleman. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
11 yards, but still not enough. Fourth down.
He dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Austin Hooper from 4 yards out, and the Falcons will add on to their lead. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Down is Brady. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Adrian Claiborne in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Throwing now is Brady. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From midfield, here's Brady. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They run. This is Lewis. Oh, he's got a little daylight. The 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Deion Lewis, 50 yards. And the Patriots have cut it back within a score. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down right around the 26. So out come the Falcons now. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways, but right now, you got to like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. On second down, Ryan. Buying time to his, and a big loss here as he's taken down.
Well, we knew this guy wasn't especially fleet of foot, but he tried to conjure up some escapability, but there was no way he was getting away on that one.
So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Hits his target, it's Tanner Gabriel. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Here we go on fourth down with Ryan. Finding Gabriel complete. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. It'll be a pickup of 13 on the play. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Here's Colvin. And an alley to run. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. That good for 22 and a first down.
That looked like a two-deep coverage, which we call cover two. And what that really means is you have corners, what we call rolled up in about a five-yard area on the outside receivers. Then your safeties are back closer to the hash marks near the middle of the field, somewhere around 10 to 12 yards back. So if you can break through the first level, you've got a chance to run before you encounter any type of resistance from the safeties.
We saw the example of it right there.
17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
And that's the connection, Ryan to Jones, that this defense obviously has to key in on.
Certainly feels like they got the party started with that one, doesn't it? And when those two get in sync, it just scares the heck out of defenses because he can hit Julio Jones in a short zone, and he can take it the whole way.
Second and 10, it's Ryan again. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 12. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. We don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right?
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Oh, and now he bowls him over.
And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game. The effort of the man with the football getting away from one and trying to churn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. A gain of four that time as the drive continues. On first and 10, here's Brady. Amendola catching it left side. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of six there on first. To throw on second down. Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Brady to Gronkowski. They make it look easy, don't they? And it's a Patriot first down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now Brady. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right.
Dumps it off to Lewis. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A minute 57 to go in this first half. Back to Foxborough after this. On first down, Brady sets up the screen to Lewis. And he'll go down at the 28. A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's second down.
Instead of the running back in New England, sometimes they like to call him the passing back. So they get him the ball in different ways, don't they?
They certainly do. Think about the ones they've had in recent vintage. You talk about Kevin Falk, Danny Woodhead, Shane Vereen, James White could have been the MVP in the Super Bowl if it wasn't for a certain quarterback that was on the field that day.
The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Now a play fake here on first down. eluding the pressure right. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
Terrific coverage in the end zone that time. Forced him out of the pocket to his right. I thought maybe try and run it there, but no one came open for him. Nice job by the defense of not getting out of their lanes.
This is Lewis, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Big boys down there in the trenches in a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And he's got it. And he's brought down. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. That time a slant, Brady in general on those quick hitters, he just releases the ball so fast.
He does, and he's so accurate, but most of the time, he wins before the ball's even snapped by his pre-snap read. Finds out where the defense is and delivers it to the proper place.
And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line.
Well, add that play to his resume reel because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that.
And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Brandon Cooks as the first half is winding down. And the Pats able to cash in for six. So they're able to capture the lead here just before halftime.
And not only that, they get the ball to start the second half.
That's right.
This is almost like basketball down the stretch, right, where you get the two-for-one situation. You're trying to get two shots to your opponent's one. In this situation, they got the touchdown. They'll get another shot at to start the second half.
Could be a big turnaround. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And Jones has it over the middle. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Final play of the half, it's Ryan. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays just as what we saw, a free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Down, Ryan. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Hey, partner, I want to sidestep for a second. Week 15, Raiders Cowboys. I know you saw that crazy first down measurement. Very, very controversial.
Look, it didn't pass the eye test. And what I mean by that is when they put the ball down and brought the chains out, you couldn't just look at it and say first down or not. Ball's, you know,
the nose of the ball was over. I mean, you had everyone eyeing it, looking at it. It's about making sure the posts are directly at 90 degrees. Do you need a leveler out there? I mean, everything was going on in the discussion. And finally, Gene Steratore, the referee, pulls an index card out of his back pocket to slide it between the football and the marker and signals first down. Now, we haven't seen that since, what, Bill Vinovich?
Yeah.
Was that 2013? Not an everyday occurrence, but you do what you have to do to get the job done. So anyone wants to put a computer chip in the football, this is a great time to bring that idea back.
I think Jack Del Rio might want to put a chip in the football.
No doubt.
On second down, here's Ryan. Now this is Gabriel on the catch. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Ryan finding Gabriel for the Falcon first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Ryan, and he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. From the gun, it's Ryan. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there and a New England first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Over the middle, that's taken in by Gronkowski. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A gain of 32 that time. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Brady now on first down. Gronkowski got it on the crossing route. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Now Brady. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. A good convergence there defensively. Only a yard, and it's second down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner. Everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short gain.
They'll give him a yard on the play, and they're going to face a third down. So five plays on this drive, Charles, all passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
Throwing the out route and complete. It's Hogan. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Brady. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's first and goal. Brady now to throw. Flushed out right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Dontari Poe breaking through to get him for a loss of 7. Now Brady throwing on second down. And caught by Hogan for a Patriot touchdown. Chris Hogan, a 15-yard touchdown grab.
And the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. So their woes on offense continue. That's the second pick thrown here in the third quarter.
And we know it was ill-advised, but that was an opportunity to help them get back into the game. Instead, he throws another interception, and now their task is even tougher.
He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. They go play action here on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. And now it's second down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
To throw on third down, Brady. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And that will push this lead up to 20 now. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And he's going to be out of bounds here as the run back will leave him shy of the 20-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. It's incomplete. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time, and that'll make it third down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. It's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him.
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Back now in Foxborough. It's the Falcons. They'll have the football, but trailing on the scoreboard as we get set to begin the fourth. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And an alley to run. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. 6 interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and we've seen it, but it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. It's Desmond Trufant.
And they finally put it into this return, but not before he's all the way down on the 37. So they get the takeaway, but that's just step one. They still have a lot of work to do.
But they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still a three-score game, though, fourth quarter.
Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jones. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A good pickup there of 20 yards. Now Ryan on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Super Bowl 49 hero Malcolm Butler. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. So after the INT, it's Brady. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he takes it down deep into Atlanta territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 78 yards. Into the red zone, it's Brady. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Robert Alford. Accelerating and off he goes. And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons.
This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Adrian Claiborne. Getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon. Brady to throw on second down. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
New England on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and 19. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Letting one go deep here for and intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Falcons turn that interception into a touchdown. And the lead will shrink to six. Here's Bosher to kick it away. On the last drive. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16. Stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Decent start defensively to this series. They've got to stop them here and get this ball back.
I like the way you phrase that, partner. Decent start, but now it's got to be more about the ball. It's all about the ball, getting it away from them, because making good tackles is one thing, but the clock will run out on you. You've got to have the football back for your offense.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And now a first down following that long gain. Throwing on first down is Brady. And Cooks has it over the middle. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. 23 yards on the play. And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. He's at the 50, the 30, past the 20. And he takes this one back into the... Went to that well too many times there.
Yeah, and it's so difficult to determine how many times is too many, because how many times have we seen a team go and play and say, until they stop us, we'll keep going. But they got stopped on that one, and it cost them 6 points.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Brady now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You have to really navigate against a tough defense.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
And that one, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
They run. Devontae Freeman. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Second down following the run. Oh, look at this. Ryan's going to throw it. There's some space here. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line. You got the slim lead late and the football, so why are you throwing it there?
Remember during the year when we asked one of the head coaches, you know, if you're in this spot, why would you throw the ball? And he talked about trust in his quarterback and trust in his offense.
But still.
And then at the end he kind of went, yeah, not really a good reason.
Right. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. He's back to throw. And right side caught Hogan. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Shift together here from the D-line. Back to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Now they'll run with Lewis. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. They'll look to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. Not good. They didn't move the football an inch, and precious time ticking off the clock. And a strange one here, a little befuddled. They're sending out the field goal unit now. This to take the lead here in the final minute. And this has no chance. It's no good. Well, wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. So we would have figured that one to be 3 points in the bank, but this game, you know, it can be unpredictable at times.
Yeah, he knew he needed to pull it ever so slightly to get it going in the right direction, but he seemed to put a little too much on it, and from short range, that is a bad miss for an NFL kicker.
They'll eat some clock with Freeman. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now whistles blow and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Again, they'll run with Freeman. Breaks the tackle, now with Alley. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. So how about